Hey, what's going on, guys? So I'm actually supposed to be on vacation from YouTube for the week. In a couple hours, I'm actually going to be getting on a plane, going to Alaska. And I had intended to not make any videos this week, but we've had a lot of big Call of Duty leaks to happen in the past 48 to 72 hours. So I kind of just wanted to bring everyone up to speed on pretty much everything that we know from this, from right now and that we've gotten in the past couple days. Okay, so if you guys remember when I initially made a video about Call of Duty 2016, I was telling you guys how there was strong reason to believe that one of the pre-order bonuses for Call of Duty 2016, at that time we didn't know the name, would be Call of Duty 4, Modern Warfare 1. And that was pretty much confirmed by a Snapchat screenshot from a Target employee, I believe, who basically took a picture of the production card for Call of Duty Infinite Warfare, which is what Call of Duty 2016 is being called. So we now know that it is officially Call of Duty Infinite Warfare. That's the official title. So no Ghosts 2 for those of you who didn't want Ghosts. No Modern Warfare 4 for people like me, and it looks like it's a completely new direction. But the important thing here to take note of is that Call of Duty 4 is going to be a remastered version. So it's not like a backwards compatible version of Call of Duty 4. We're getting a completely graphically reamped and updated version of Call of Duty Modern Warfare 1, which is, it's just absolutely incredible. I don't even know how I'm going to split the time playing Infinite Warfare and COD 4. I'm assuming, given the fact that I've been right about a leak coming out in the next couple weeks, that's what I said in my last COD 2016 video, given the fact that I was also correct about Call of Duty 4 being a pre-order bonus, I'm assuming that this is going to take place somewhere in the very distant future in kind of like a space combat type sequence, shit like that. I don't even know. But that's what I'm assuming so far. Now, once again, we're not going to get any gameplay, at least official gameplay, until E3, which is just a little bit over a month. So we've got a little bit of time to go for Activision to put out things like that. They're going to be actually revealing it as part of the PlayStation 4, like Sony's little conference thing, which probably means that we're going to be getting console exclusives for PlayStation 4 owners in terms of getting DLC first before Xbox users and things like that. So just a lot of really exciting information going on in the past couple days in terms of Call of Duty 2016. Like I said, I'm still thinking that we are going to be getting something really far into the distant future, especially with a name like Infinite Warfare. I mean, it just kind of sounds like something that's going to be along the lines of a Halo or things like that. But I'm going to be putting links to all the things that I've gone over in this video in the description so you can read them in a lot more detail than I really have time to go into right now. And let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. How are you going to divvy up your time with COD 4 and Infinite Warfare and anything else that we may be getting? Now, COD 4, I believe that's coming in it's called the Legacy Edition. So I'm not sure if that's going to be basically Infinite Warfare's version of the Hardened Edition for Black Ops 3, or if that's going to be the really expensive over $100 edition, which in that case I may still have to get, given the fact you're getting two really good games, or at least one, because we know COD 4 is good. So yeah, guys, thanks for checking out the video. If you've not done so already, please be sure to subscribe to the channel, help me grow, and I'll see you guys on my next video sometime next week when I get back. I'm out, guys.